I made all this in less than a week. But how? Hello everyone, welcome back to my weekend updates. If you're new here, just so you know, I'm working on a voxel-based game, which is in very early stages of development. But this week's video is a little different. Me and one of my best friends, Patrick, have been working super hard for the last few weeks on a Vulkan abstraction library, which is open source under the MIT license. The last week has been a lot of bug testing, and for that, I've written several samples of how to learn to use the API from the ground up. But let's go over all the features that Daxa 1.0 has. Daxa completely abstracts away raw Vulkan and allows you to write much more concise code. You can still select a physical device based on its attributes, but it's much less cumbersome. You can create compute shaders to drastically speed up things that are easily parallelizable, such as chunk generation, or even rendering. You can very easily create and upload meshes to the GPU with the automatically managed and recycled buffers. You can upload and create textures, and the IDs of these resources retrieved from the API is the same within the C++ CPU code as it is in the HLSL code on the GPU side. Also, everything is bindless. There are no descriptors, binding sets, or anything like that. You can very easily create multiple render targets and draw them, which is useful for things like cascaded shadow mapping. Lastly, the things to come are helper utilities, such as IMGUI for making debug user interfaces, FSR 2.0 for upscaling and anti-aliasing, and most importantly, Task Graph, which reduces the last annoying part of Vulkan, which is the redundant, error-prone, and cumbersome synchronization. Daxa is the backend for my voxel project, and so it has been designed with real-world use in mind. There are still a few quirks to sort out, but I will update the description and/or pin a comment when the official 1.0 release is out. Thank you guys for watching.